Welcome to the Torah Anytime, Tisha B'Av, Burst of Inspiration. We like to speak about the cause of the Horban, Habayit, the destruction of Beit HaMikdash. Chachamim tell us an interesting insight why the destruction have happened. The Gemara says in B'Matzia Peihei, Amar Yudah Amarav, Mai Dichtiv Me'ish V'Chacham V'Yaven Et Zot V'Asher Diber Pi Adonai Ela V'Yagida Al Ma Avda Aretz. Why was the land destroyed? The Gemara says that the reply came from Hashem. Vayomer Adonai al ozvam et torati asher natati lifnehem. They abandoned my Torah. Amar Yudah Amarav shelo birchu b'Torah tchila. People did not say the beracha for the Torah first. What does that mean? Well, there are different perushim to the meaning of that Gemara, but I saw an interesting perush, and I like to share it. And that is based on what Chachamim tell us, that one must give first an honor to the Talmid Chacham. The Gemara says, Kol Talmid Chacham shemefarech lefanav, afilu kohen gadol am haaretz, oto Talmid Chacham chayav mita, which means, a Talmid Chacham always must be honored first, before everybody else. Even before a Kohen Gadol, says the Gemara. Even more so, the Gemara says that if a Kohen Gadol, and obviously others also, but even a Kohen Gadol that says Bracha before the Talmid Chacham, Chayav Mita, harsh punishment. What kind of Bracha? There are two kinds of Brachot that we're talking about. One is Birkat HaTorah, when a person goes up to the Torah first. When there is an Aliyah, who gets first the Aliyah? Usually, it's Kohen Levi Israel. According to strict halakha, it should have been that the Talmid Chacham would go first, even before Kohen, and even before Kohen Gadol. Later on, it was changed in order so people would not start fighting over the Aliyot. Also, some say, Kaf HaChaim brings down, that today it's not anymore that honor to give a first Aliyah, but rather Talmid Chacham would rather, let's say, sometimes Aliyah Shishi or others, so therefore, the honor is Dafka on a different Aliyah. But the point is the same point, that a Talmid Chacham goes before even a Kohen on the Brachot. On, for instance, Birkat HaZimun, Talmid Chacham goes before a Kohen, although by Kohen there's a mitzvah deoraita v'kidashto, he goes first l'chol davar shebakdusha, but Talmid Chacham is before that Kohen. Now, Talmid Chacham is allowed halachically to give the Kohen to go before him, but not because he's a Kohen, because he wants to give him the honor and respect him as a person. But if he gives him the honor of a Kohen, he shows by that the Keuna is greater than a Talmid Chacham, than Keter Torah. And that is deserving, says the Gemara, of Mita, harsh punishment. The highest crown is Talmid Chacham. Why? Because if they see, people see, that the Talmid Chacham is under a Kohen, and he goes second, and even more so if he goes afterwards, such a thing is disrespect to the Torah, and people stop respecting the Torah. This is how important it is that the Talmid Chacham should come first. And that's what it means in the Gemara, Shelo Birchu B'Torah Tchila, which means the Talmidei Chachamim didn't go up to give the blessing on the Torah first. They didn't go to the first Aliyah. I like to point that this is a serious, serious thing, as we'll explain right now how it connects to the destruction of the Beit HaMikdash. But first of all, just few things that we need to know about that mitzvah of respecting the Talmid Chacham. It says in the Halacha, it's brought down in the Rambam and in Ilchot Talmud Torah, where it's brought down to respect the Talmidei Chachamim. Rambam writes, mitzvah taseh min haTorah lechabdam uleadram. It's a positive mitzvah to respect and honor Talmid Chacham. Velakum mipneim, you have to rise in front of them, legadel otam, you have to raise them, yesh lakdimam lechol davar shebagdula, they go first, as we just explained, for anything that's honorable, כגון לברכה, לקריאת התורה, להקדים לדון דין תורה שיש להם, להרבות בכבודם עד מאוד. You have to honor them very, very much. אף על פי שאתה רואה אותם עניים ומדולדלים, even though sometimes they look in your eyes that they are poor, they're disrespected, we are commended to raise them up. צריך לנהוג בהם כבוד. אמרו חכמים, אין כבוד אל התורה. כלומר, אין לך אדם שראוי לתת לו כבוד יותר ממה שהוא בעל תורה. We usually make a mistake in that. We honor those that have a profession, doctor, lawyer, judge. תמיד חכם, he's on the side. It's the opposite. We usually respect the person that has money. Person that has money, you should respect his pocket, not him. His pocket is honorable. תמיד חכם, it's a חפצה of honor. שנאמר כבוד, חכמים ינחלו. The pasuk says that the honor belongs to the חכמים. ועוד אמרו שכל יודע בחברו שהוא גדול ממנו אפילו בדבר אחד. Even if your friend is higher than you, in one thing, he knows one thing more than you do, אפילו לא למד ממנו דבר. Even if you didn't still learn that from him, חייב לנהוג בו כבוד. And it goes on and on. It says that a person must love Talmidei Chachamim, and so on. Definitely, disrespecting Talmid Chacham has a harsh, harsh punishment, as the Halacha brings down. The Gemara even calls such a person an apikoris, if he disrespects Talmidei Chachamim. Or even, says the Gemara, if you respect your friend in front of Talmid Chacham. Sometimes in front of Talmid Chacham, you'll see a friend and you'll speak to him in disrespect. You wouldn't do that if you were right near the president, right near the mayor, over there, you'll be on your best behavior. Near your boss, you'll react to your friends in a different way. Even more so to your boss. But just in front of your boss, you'll respect your friend very differently. Why is it different when we're dealing with Talmidei Chachamim? Because of the disrespect we have. Says the Ma'aril, an interesting insight. Listen to this. The Ma'aril says that Hashem Yitbarach mashpia chesed umerachem al olamo. And there's two things that Hashem brings to the world, chesed v'rachamim. What are the difference? Chesed is a constant mercy that Hashem has in the world. A certain ashpa'a that makes the world exist, that shouldn't be everything according to the judgment. But rather, HaKadosh Baruch Hu does in a way that will be bearable for people to live without just being judged all the time in heavenly court. And Rachamim is when Am Yisrael, or when a person is in a time of a need, HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives him those Rachamim, those extra mercy, although sometimes he doesn't deserve of it. But says the Ma'aril, in Netzach Yisrael, Perek Mem Zayin, דבר זה, כאשר ישראל עושים המשפט והצדק, you only receive that חסד ורחמים when עם ישראל following the law exactly to the teeth. אשר דבר זה ראוי לאדם לעשות מצד שהוא אדם, כי אם לא יעשה משפט, if you don't do the law according to the way it should be, הרי יוצא מן הדבר שהוא מחויב לעשות, וכן הצדק, הוא ראוי שיעשה הדבר של הצדק, כאשר למטה עושים מה שראוי להם, לעשות למטה, גם השם יתברך עושה להם מה שראוי לעשות, והוא החסד והרחמים. הקדוש ברוך הוא showers us with mercy only when we do exactly what we need to do, משפט וצדק, which means according to the Torah. And that's what it's explained in Rashi, in דברים י' א', ונתתם את הר ארציכם, Rashi says, ועשיתם מה שעליכם, אף אני אעשה מה שעליי. If you do what you need to do, I'll do what I need to do. What is it? הקדוש ברוך הוא יעשה את שלו, היינו ברכה שהיא צריכה אל הבריאות. הקדוש ברוך הוא will give us the chesed or rachamim, that's what he does. Only if we do what we need to do. Keep the Torah exactly the way it should be. Who's the one that teaches us what needs to be done exactly? That is exactly the Talmidei Chachamim who learn the Torah and know the Torah precisely. And that's why the Ma'aril brings in another place that the reason for the destruction, Chachamim tell us, on Shabbat Kuf Yutet, lo charva Yerushalayim ela bishvil shebizu batalmidei Chachamim. Yerushalayim was destroyed because the degraded Talmidei Chachamim, says the Maharil that the reason they were Mevazeh Talmidei Chachamim is because they didn't want to learn from them exactly what the law is, what the halacha is. והשכל הנבדל הוא מחויב, כי עניין השכל מחויב ומוכרח. לכך כל עניין השכל במידת הדין, the שכל, the mind of the Talmid Chacham that knows exactly how to learn the Torah and teaches us exactly the way it should be, הדבר הוא מחויב ומוכרח, הוא במידת הדין. That would be במידת הדין. When we follow the law exactly the way it should be, and who teaches us the way the Torah should be, that is the Talmid Chacham, then HaKadosh Baruch Hu does the Chesed and the Rachamim. Says the Maharil, the Chorban HaBayit came because Am Yisrael at that time did not respect the Talmid Chacham, and therefore each one learned the Torah the way he himself understood. When you learn the Torah according to your understanding, it's not exactly the way the Torah should be. And since it's not exactly, you're not fulfilling the mitzvot exactly the way the Torah wants us to fulfill. You have your own twist to it. If that's the way it is, Kadosh Baruch Hu says, only when you do exactly what you need to do, bedin, then I'll give you the chesed and the rachamim. But what Am Yisrael had in that generation is the mistake to think that you could do differently, and therefore the chesed and rachamim have stopped. We learn from this how important it is in our generation to listen to our rabbis, to our Gedolei Ador, not to use our own mind to twist the Torah the way we understand. May Hashem be mezakeh us that this should be the last Tisha B'Av, and next year we'll celebrate in Yerushalayim HaBnuyah.